Life can change in an instant. For Andy Boone, a split second would change his life forever.
The date was May 22nd, 2014. It was weird. I could tell what kind of truck it was. It was a Ford F-250. I mean, it's weird how you could tell that in a split second. I remember I actually was saying it out loud, why? And then the cab filled up with smoke, which was from the airbag. From where I got hit to where I ended up was about 150 yards. So I spun actually for about 150 yards. Ended up right here on the side of the road, facing the opposite direction, kind of at an angle right here. And I was here for about 30 minutes till they got me cut out. From the time it happened and they cut me out, it was about 30, 45 minutes.
And I just, they're like, he's in the ambulance. And I look over in the yard and I look at what's left of his vehicle. And I mean, my heart is just, it just drops because I'm like, it doesn't even look like a truck. It doesn't look like a vehicle.
Boone was in a head-on car collision with a larger vehicle. He was pinned inside and needed to be cut out. His heel was shattered. And so it seemed was his career as one of the top high school football coaches in central Louisiana. At Avoyelles High School, Boone inherited a program that had won only 3 games in the previous 5 seasons. But by Boone's 3rd season, the coach had Avoyelles positioned as a mainstay in the Louisiana State playoffs, thanks in part to a double-wing offense paired with an unconventional football philosophy. Boone chooses to go for 2 after every touchdown. Every kickoff is an onside kick, and the team hasn't punted the football in 7 years. And now the coach was facing the same uphill challenge of toughness that he'd so often preached to his players.
Pretty much for 6 weeks after my accident, I had to sit in a chair, basically, or in bed, with my foot up, elevated, off my feet, couldn't walk. But I was on crutches for almost 8 months. You know, I had to give up my marathon running, you know, all my running, I can't do anymore. Not that I ran, but I can't run, so if something's gonna chase me, I'm gonna get caught. Couldn't put any weight on my foot for around 6 weeks. So that was tough when you're always used to moving and moving around and going.
It was a nightmare for me, because I couldn't do anything to make it better for him. And it was a nightmare for him because he was having to live through it.
Became depressed that summer. You can only watch so many reruns of TV.
This gutsy, aggressive approach to the game of football matches the same approach Coach Boone applied to his recovery.
He's worked very hard to rebuild strength in that leg.
You know, it still hurts. By the end of the day, it'll start hurting because it swells up.
Getting back into a routine was huge for Boone's recovery.
Getting back to a sense of normalcy, getting back around the kids, getting back to lifting weights, being at school, getting back into your everyday routine. It mentally just puts you back into your, you know, where you want to be, you know, into your safe place, into where you're comfortable.
Despite the accident, Boone is very happy things were not even worse.
But I am thankful that I'm alive.
He still gets up and he does all the stuff that he was doing before. And with every step, he's in pain. And I admire that, because that is somebody who is going to take care of his family and is going to take care of what he needs to do.
Years after his injury, Coach Boone has learned to live with the pain and, much like the players he coaches, push past adversity. For the Southeastern Times, I'm Wesley Boone.